This is the Chab Dog Sports Talk Show. We're ADHD hosts that are OCD about our sports. Host Brandon Chabner brings you Eric the Well-Read, Frank the Tank, and Boston Mark for sports talk that's breaking news everywhere else. Now here's your host, Brandon Chabner.
All right, hello everybody, and welcome to another edition of Chab Dog Sports Talk. We're on each Sunday from 9 to 11 a.m. Pacific Time, brought to you by Chabner Law, serving Southern California's transactional legal needs, and by Chab Dog Sports Blog for your ahead of your sports headlines and biting sports commentary. And it's kind of a drab day here in Southern California, isn't it, Eric?
Hey, Chab Dog. Yes, hey. It's gray. It hasn't rained yet, but boy, those clouds look dark. It's something's coming. Something's brewing out there off the Pacific here in Southern California.
Yeah, just what we need.
It looks like a shit storm.
Nobody's gonna be able to get outside their house if that happens, and we'll really be stuck.
Well, and as a matter of fact, I was just texting that I was woken up at 2 a.m. this morning.
By what?
By the sound of my neighbors having an argument. A loud and voracious argument.
I was thinking you would have said something about an orgasm.
Yeah, I wish. No, I'm in lockdown, so there's no dating life for me.
Well, maybe the guy next door.
Well, this is the apartment. Oh, yeah, exactly. And they should, rather than lovemaking, they were...
How bad was it? Was it? Were you afraid?
Well, she was getting most of the jabs in... Call here. It's Frank the Tank. So she was getting most of the jabs in and going on for like a good half hour, and I was thinking, man, I didn't hear anything physical, and I was thinking, boy, this guy can really take it.
Yeah,
because she's just
going on and on,
just going on
which
and on.
Often
and on.
Happens when they get going.
And then finally, in the end, he sticks up for himself and just loses it. And I could hear him real loud. I thought, right on, buddy. I mean, you know what? Then it was quiet.
So he let her exhaust herself.
So back to being stuck up and cabin fever. I think we got cabin fever already. This rain is just going to make it worse. Let's hear how things are going in New Jersey. We've got Frank the Tank has just called in. Frank Fleming of Sports Encyclopedia, sportsencyclopedia.com, for all of your sports information going back centuries and teams that don't even exist anymore. And, of course, a major contributor over at Barstool. In fact, my favorite Barstoolie, Frank Fleming. Frank, how you doing?
Freedom's dead forever. We have no life now. We should just drink some poison and die. We'll be better off. We'll be done with this fucking nightmare, misery, glass, forever, forevermore.
Is that good?
Mm-hmm.
How's that? Does that answer your question, how I'm doing?
Yep. It does very, very eloquently as well.
Well, at least you don't live in New York City.
Well, it's close enough.
Yeah, close enough.
I mean, your statistical rates have to mirror what's going on in New York City, right?
No comment.
He's finishing a soda. But that's the bigger problem. You know, they're going to ban sodas. You can't get a soda. They're going to ban meat, so you're going to have to be a vegan.
They've already banned rim... What did you call that thing?
Oh, yeah, they banned rim jobs.
Rim
jobs. Not that I was really fighting for rim jobs, but again, it's totalitarian communist state.
Yeah, what's this world coming to? You can't even get a good rim job anymore.
Yeah. Freedom to do rim jobs removed. It's horrible. So, Tank, that was a great film you did this week on YouTube, the tour of your apartment.
I have to see that. Is that, how can we get that, Frank?
Well, it's on YouTube, and we go to what, Frank Fleming, just search YouTube, just type in your
just
name,
go
Frank
to your
Fleming
YouTube
with one
channel.
Find it.
Uh-huh. Pardon me?
I think you should be able to find it by looking up my name.
Yeah, exactly.
Did you prepare for that? Did you clean your apartment really, really well? And
oh, he does. He dusted
I don't have the energy to clean my apartment.
you haven't had the energy to clean it for years by the looks of it.
He's totally honest.
He is.
Just like me. It really takes...
I don't like doing it. It sucks. It
takes a modicum of
energy. I'm cluttered in here anyway, so I just have things piled in corners as neatly as possible.
Yeah.
Well, what's the story about the air conditioner in your bedroom?
I had an air conditioner in my bedroom. I live on the ground floor, as you know.
Right.
So, every 2 weeks, they have a guy just blows all the dirt and dust with a leaf blower, even though there's no leaves. So all the silt from the ground ended up in my air conditioner and destroyed it.
Oh, wow.
Just your luck.
Yeah. Yeah, would have plugged it right up, of course.
Well, we thought of you this week. We got some good New Jersey clips.
Mm-hmm.
I got the... we have the Joe Piscopo doing Frank Sinatra singing New Jersey, New Jersey?
Really?
Yeah. Don't you have that?
Oh, I got Joe Piscopo.
Oh.
Is it this one?
This one, yeah.
All right.
Play this.
Hall of Fame class of 2013 and our host for the evening, Joe Piscopo.
Anybody from Jersey in the house? Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. NJ. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through each and every toll booth on the Garden State Parkway. I wanna wake up where the diners do not close. Take the turnpike past exit 13, holding my nose. My New York Philly blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new exit of it in old NJ. If we can here, we're gonna make it anywhere. It's up to you, NJ. We love you, New York. We love you, Philly. But this is Jersey, baby.
Yeah, Jersey.
In a traffic jam on 287, root for the Giants and Jets. Say goodbye to the Nets. And like Vince Lombardi, name a rest stop for me.
Yeah, Vince Lombardi.
All those Italians and Jews. Mamma mia, oy vey. I wanna pay the highest possible property tax, and we don't care how much our governor may weigh. But you better believe in me. If you can make it here, you're gonna make it absolutely anywhere. It's up to you, NJ. It's New Jersey, baby, USA.
Yeah, I'd never seen that before. What do you think of that, Tank? Is that accurate?
Did you ever hear that?
It bring tear to your eyes?
Never heard that before, but yeah, it's pretty accurate.
Yeah.
You got to hold your nose at by the exit number 13?
Exit 13 is a bad exit, I guess.
Exit 13 is where they had, like all the chemical plants. It's the seaport.
Yeah.
And not too far from the airport.
Yep.
Yeah. I remember seeing that when I drove up from Maryland with my family to visit my parents in Scarsdale. We'd always have to drive up that exit. The Jersey Turnpike, and I remember that part of
it. Yeah, it's by the seaport, the airport, the chemical plants are out there.
Great air.
Yep, great view.
Very healthy for you. Yeah. So,
but that being said, I mean, New Jersey, it's not called the Garden State just for some random reason. It really is. Most of it is beautiful, agricultural, bucolic.
Yeah, right.
It doesn't look like Newark or...
Hey, that's where Princeton is. Isn't it?
The factories, yeah.
A very, very lush
part
of New
Jersey. But
Newark's
the brick city. It's got a lot of history, too. I mean, Newark goes back to colonial times, doesn't it?
Yeah, the town is 1666.
There you go. Are there any architecture left from that period?
No, not really. There's a couple of churches that are from like the... about 300 years old, but that's about it.
Okay. That's still pretty good. I mean, it's a lot older than anything here in L.A. So, of your many running battles going on Facebook this week, which one comes to mind? Either which one was your favorite, or which one did you just think people were stupid?
Fucking communists.
Oh, the commies? So,
they actually enjoyed this. I actually think they did... They're happy that everything is shut down.
Uh-huh.
Frank, do you have people that are like constantly fighting, the same people fighting with you on Facebook? Is it just a recurring thing? Are they friends of yours, or are they just people that are trolling?
A couple of more work acquaintances. A fucking commie liberal public defenders.
Oh, okay.
So this is
a job here.
This is just like an ongoing thing.
Is one of them that Mets fan, that socialist Mets fan? Like a Leninist or something? I think I commented to him or brought it up in a light way anyway. Yeah. Okay, that explains it then. Oh yeah, they're like, man, talk about liberal
public
defenders.
It hasn't reached the point where you found it necessary to sever the ties. It's just
Tag doesn't. You don't. You don't.
Don't you do that eventually if they're just being abusive or something?
It's just terrible. It's horrible. And now it's taking it's like we have to wait. Now we're outside. Get in the fucking store now. It's pathetic. It's putrid.
I know. I feel like such a.
How long do you have to stand outside 10 minutes before
it's
you
so
get in,
dehumanizing
right?
All the time. You know, if it's not seeing these people walking around with a mask to seeing lines of cars waiting to get it through Starbucks drive through, or watching the people lined up like little peons waiting to get into Trader Joe's and separated by the 10 feet apart and stuff.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Trader's is really taking it serious here. They're like
Nazis. We're just forced into this existence. It's
commie Nazis.
It's dehumanizing. That's all I can say.
Yeah, this is not what we're set up for. This is not America.
And I know we're not supposed to complain about it because we're all supposed to be in this together and we got to get through it together.
Well, we can all complain together too. I mean, let's be honest.
Yeah, we might as well be able to vent a little bit.
Mm-hmm. So, Tank, I've got an interesting
question.
Sorry, go ahead.
You know, they're now basically, that no matter how people die, if they have a heart attack, it's COVID-19.
If they had any in their system.
Well, I think
it's probably not a causation at all. It's just, okay, did you have it in your system when you died? And if you did, okay, then you're one of the numbers.
Well, I still think that's better than China, where everyone dies and they won't say it was from COVID. Bullshit. They got 3,200 deaths
know,
in a country of 1.4 billion.
Too extreme.
What, you think I'm fucking stupid?
It's two extremes.
Yeah,
it's
that's ridiculous.
While they did that, they had Nancy Pelosi said, "We admire the Chinese and the job they've done.
Yep,
they've done a good job.
Mm-hmm.
So, and we take their numbers seriously. We believe them fully.
Mm-hmm. So, Frank, it sounds like you're
fully wrong.
You're thinking there might be some collusion with China.
Collusion.
Yes.
What, between
between the Democrats and China?
Yeah, not the United States, but the Democratic Party.
The anti-Trump forces in China.
Sure, they are. Well, they don't like him either. Yeah, if China could get rid of the president, they want him out as well. He's their enemy.
Maybe there'll be an investigation into this when all's said and done.
I mean, it was the Democratic Party that opened up relations with China.
I tell you, if anybody was involved in unleashing this crap on us, that's gonna be a hanging offense.
Oh, but Tank, you already put it out there, Tank. The lawsuit for how many trillions of dollars do we want to sue China for now?
You know that will never happen because everyone's a fucking coward.
Well, not, hey, wait and see what America does when it starts to hit our pocketbook.
I think
people are cowards when that happens.
Eric's interested in this. He's very interested in this.
Well, and Tank brought this up. He brought up, reprinted
our... Well, it's delightful that we're finally going to see the death of capitalism. Him and Michael Moore.
Yeah, this is it's not too far-fetched to say this could kill it. Because, printing $2 trillion, $4 trillion, who knows what it's going to ultimately be at the end of the day.
And shutting our economy down.
Well, and printing paper to fill in the gap is what they're doing here, but that's not how capitalism works. You can't do that because you're paying for work that didn't happen. And you can't, and that's inflation. It's when you buy a bad asset, you say, okay, we're going to make you whole on this.
It's hyperinflation.
Here. It's when...
It's Weimar Germany.
Potentially, it could lead to that. But Weimar, here's the only difference, though. It's Germany wasn't the reserve currency of the world.
What the Weimar Republic led to.
Yeah. Yeah, it led to... so are you saying Trump is Hitler?
Led to Adolf.
Yeah.
No, he's saying it's going to lead to Hitler.
A different, whole different animal. We're talking maybe someone like Omar. With a different philosophy of people being put into showers.
Oh, but Ilhan and Omar wasn't born in the United States, so she can never be president.
Well, then AOC.
Yeah, she's under 35, so she can't be president.
Yeah, but 10 years from now.
She'll be assassinated along the way, don't worry. 75 million Americans own weapons. One of us will get it taken care of. You know, we're the largest army in the world is American gun owners. And I'm not joking. Like, stop and think. We are the largest standing army in the fucking world. Nobody else has got 75 million armed people with one cause in their mind. Nobody else. Mm.
So that's our ace in the hole.
That's our ace in the hole, yeah.
Yeah.
That's our ultimate security. And I think when it came down to it, if things were going sideways in a handbasket and the police weren't able to keep order, citizens with weapons will, our own communities will keep the order. And we'll have to.
That's what they wanted to take all the guns.
Well, yeah, then, I mean, good luck in New York. You people are screwed because you got, the people with guns are going to set your order. It's going to be like gangs in New York stuff, like last week.
Oh, what a great movie.
Yeah, but in more urban areas where, people are well-armed, it'll be
did
fun.
We play the Gangs in New York clip last week?
Of course we played. Yeah. We loved it, man. That's we right. got all over that.
I don't know if Frank heard that.
Frank, you ever see the Omega Man? Or remember that movie? Charlton Heston, 1971?
I never saw it. I saw the remake. The remake was, meh.
I Am Legend. It was, yeah. Here, check this out. This is how the world ended in 1971.
They destroyed the world.
The entire Los Angeles area. Already hospital facilities have begun to crack under the strain.
It's like today.
And civil defense authorities state that the situation is much the same across the entire country. Martial law is now nationwide.
Yeah, we have to
major cities in all
law.
Parts of the country, New York, Los Angeles, report plague victims falling dead in the streets, in their homes, at their work. The first symptom appears to be severe choking, followed by immediate unconsciousness. Death occurs within minutes.
Whether a state of war between China and Russia still exists is not important any longer. Our fellow countrymen are dying. The very foundations of civilization are beginning to crumble under the dread assault of that horror long feared germ warfare.
Conorad Channel, this is a Class 1 emergency. All civilian traffic is barred from streets and highways. Stay in your homes. Stay in your homes. Those found without specific military orders are subject to summary execution. Stay in your homes. Repeat, Conorad Channel, this is a Class 1 emergency. All civilian traffic is barred from streets and highways.
Okay, so that's, you know, just on the lighter side.
Sounds like a lockdown to me.
Well, it's a lot. Yeah, but we're not that bad. You know, that might be a hopefully not a portend of things to come, but we're not that bad.
Mm.
Okay, so here's something I did want to bring up.
Mm-hmm.
And Tank, I wanted to really get your take on this. So let's take the NFL and let's say, what's your prediction? Are we even going to have an NFL season, Tank?
We're going to have nothing ever again.
Okay.
Nothing ever again.
Well, let's back. This might be one of our last radio shows if that happens. Because yeah, but let's back up. Let's say it's. I want to give you a scenario where we don't have an NFL, but life does somehow move on, and we get the light at the end of the tunnel somewhere down the road. But in the meantime, okay, how are you going to pay? Well, in fact, let's back up and just take baseball. Do you pay the players this year if they never play a game?
I think it's a
fourth. Yep, that's what they said they're going to do.
Really?
That money coming from, though? Ticket sales alone? Because there's no TV money.
Well, I mean, they have. I'm sure they have. You know, cash reserves. And
no, not enough to pay a whole to pay a year's payroll. No way they got that much.
Major league team?
No. Major league team.
I don't know.
This is football or baseball, Tank. You know this. They're highly leveraged business vehicles.
Yeah, you don't think they've got like $500 million in cash?
Oh, good heavens, no. Nobody's got that kind of money. Nobody, no business has that kind of money just sitting around. I mean,
a lot of the big companies.
Yeah, but that's like a $1 trillion company. I mean, that's Apple or something. But not, sports franchises are highly leveraged vehicles. And when I say highly leveraged, it means that they've not only got loans out against their assets, and they need cash flow to survive.
They kind of sound like a normal person. You know?
Yeah. So that's what I'm saying. Let's just look at it at the sports level here. Like the Mets, for instance, Tank, will ticket sales alone pay for the entire payroll for a year and cover the costs of the business with nothing else, with, say, just the season tickets?
Not. The Mets will probably have to trade, look like the Long Island Ducks.
What's that? The Ducks?
Independent minor league.
I think what do the Ducks do? They lay their players off or something?
No, they'll probably have the type of payroll that means have a bunch of nobodies on their team.
Oh, that's fine. But in the meantime,
34 and 168.
Are they going to not pay Verlander's salary, or like are they going to stop paying people?
It's just terrible.
Like, I don't really care if they said they would. How are they going to pay? How are major league teams going to pay a year's salary if there's no TV rights?
Maybe the government will help
them. And no walk-up sales.
The government will help them out.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we're going to do government bailout for sports teams now. Yes. I mean, but that's what
it's a public good.
I'm bringing this up because I don't have the answer to the question, but it's like, holy shit. No one's talking about this right now, but it's coming.
I mean, the last people I'm worried about is the players and whether they're getting paid. The last.
But everything rolls downhills. Yeah, they don't get paid. They can't pay their bills. They get foreclosed on. They get their cars repoed.
Yeah.
Okay, which goes for a lot of people.
I don't think they have a lot of, those guys are rich. They got ability to deal with this.
Not if you're a rookie. What if you're like 2 or 3 years into the contract and you've already blown your money?
Well, if you want to nitpick, they're probably
But
a
most
few
of the
people.
League is not, you know, they're the minimum salary players.
Anyway, I'm not worried about it, but they'll figure it out. If sports disappear, then they disappear. Oh, we'll just be able to talk about.
Well, that's back to Tank's scenario here, where we're all fucked, and civilization is going to break down the next few weeks, right? Tank, is that what is that your take?
Right in time for Hitler's birthday.
Ooh, that's 420. No, we'll get past 420.
Civilization will. I think that May or June things will go. That was when civilization will collapse.
Haywire.
May or June.
May or June.
Oh.
So will the courthouse, will your courthouse be closed permanently?
How am I going to sleep tonight? Jesus.
They'll lock everyone in the homes and then.
Well.
And ban me from having an eaten vegan meal. Because I'm vegan! AOC says that all meat should be banned.
Yep.
And she likes vegan.
Yep. And no sodas. Either diet or regular soda. No soda, period.
Tank,
soda's banned.
What kind of food?
No, you have to drink vinegar.
What kind of food have you been
drinking? Vinegar. It's not good. You got to drink vinegar.
Apple cider vinegar, Tank. It's healthy for you.
I want to know what you've been doing for your meals.
He's been eating well.
What have you been making?
It's all on TV.
Different things here and there. Whatever I feel like.
Wow.
Sometimes I order food. I might order food today. I don't really feel like cooking right now.
Oh. Well, I heard Papa John's has minimum contact for delivery purposes, so you really don't have to worry about anything.
The person that breathed over my sub and made a sub, goobered all over my meal.
They're wearing a mask, probably.
Yeah, they probably put the mask on backwards.
So you can order some Papa John's and not worry about it.
Well, he made a really good ham, or had a slice of ham. You had some ham earlier in the week.
You know who's got some good cooking advice is Benny Hill. Do you want to hear the part about how to cook Chinese in your house? Let's listen to this.
Oops, wrong clip.
You like Benny Hill, Frank?
Yeah, he was something different. I remember him years ago on TV.
Yeah,
we're talking 70s, 80s.
You were
80s.
Really young. We were a little older. I watched a lot of Benny Hill, but there's one that where he's doing Chinese food.
There we are. Oh, next one.
Let's see.
Yeah, here we are.
Yeah, this is good.
For those of you who'd like to learn how to cook Chinese food at home, here are Farnie and Joni Claddock.
Good evening, everybody.
Where's Joni?
Oh, Joni, hang it on your jaw, you stupid breeding area.
Sorry. He's indisposed?
As a newt.
What's this dish called?
In English, it's called politician's pudding.
Why politician's pudding?
Because into it, we put pea stalks. Pea stalks. That's a Chinese joke. Why there no crap bean? Why there no crap bean out there? Got your mouth a stupid
hearing.
You see, this fish, this is very popular with my brothel.
That's so racist.
I have a big brothel in Hong Kong and a riddle system.
My brothel?
Flogs her eggs.
Frogs.
Who flogs her eggs?
No, who flogs her eggs? Flogs her eggs. Look, flogs her eggs.
Oh,
frog legs.
Yes! Hoary Mackalaw.
I just can't believe what he's saying at the time.
Talk a road of cobras. Miss have a chop
celery.
Not necessary. Probably. Not necessary. Miss we have egg. This egg come from Kyushu bird. Kyushu bird, very unusual bird. Only have one mating season per year. This lasts for 12 months. Unfortunately, there is no female of the species. Kyushu bird is a very unhappy bird. Now, we break the egg in a pot, so... Bloody hell! Look, made in Japan! No wonder. Get another one. Oh, stupid idiot. He not want to break a pot. Make a fist.
Hmm?
Make a fist! Oh. With a hand, right. Egg, yeah. Right. We have other egg. This egg come from Leany bird. Leany bird, very rare bird. Linny bird only weigh half ounce. Smallest bird in whole world. Only weigh half an ounce. Called teeny weeny linny bird. And every year, it lay one egg. When it laid his egg, it let out a strange cry. Aha, I'm on my head. Hello, my darling. Mr. Pooh. And then his bird completely disappear. Put an egg in a pot. That's nice. That's okay. Ooh, ooh. Right, next we have some kidney.
Kidney.
I said kidney, didn't I? Right. Now, what is rarest meat in whole world? Rarest meat in the whole world.
Armadillo. Would you say armadillo?
Yes, you're a dillo. Rarest meat in whole world. Try. Come on, come on. Come on. Eat.
Couscous. Is it couscous?
No couscous, puss.
You eat bread with this?
No, we no have a bread with that. No.
Just soya dumplings.
Pardon?
Just soya dumplings.
Bloody sex mechanic or something? Stupid area. Put it in the oven.
Ah. What's after the main dish? I used to watch him sometimes.
Good body every evening. You know what I think?
Tell us what you think, Johnny. We could do with 2 minutes silence.
I think for your haftas.
Your dessert.
Your sweet.
We have
these riddle pastries.
Petit four.
Okay, a petit four.
We usually have more varied confections. Chocolate drops.
Pardon?
Chocolate drops.
Who's a clever boy, dear? Look at me when I talk to you.
And we'd start with canapés.
What's a good of bloody canapés? You know, have a peas in a high pong.
No. Canapé, it's French.
French, you can't speak a bloody English.
Look, you want a canapé? Get a canapé!
Oh, I'm gonna catch me on choice.
So sorry, stupid area. You're coming.
I can't. Yeah, it's a canopy, all right.
It's a too late to apologize.
There's no garnish. Celery. You don't sort of titivate it.
What?
Titivate.
What's a titivate? Sound like a Jewish baby waiting for the breakfast.
Waiting for the breakfast?
He's a rubbery, eh? Rubbery.
It's rubbery, all right.
Yeah. Breastfeeding.
Want to do having some? Oh, yeah.
No, I know eat that fallen muck. I have a nicer fish and chip. Oh, that's nice.
All right, we're done with that. Yeah.
Well, now that, you know, from growing up in Canada and hanging out with a lot of English people and hanging out with a lot of people from Hong Kong too. That's funny in the way that's the Chinese they're mimicking.
Yeah,
are English speaking Hong Kong Chinese. That's exactly how they pronounce and sound that. So all the Brits would have an ear for that because that was their colony for a long time until 1997.
The R's and the L's get mixed up.
Yeah. Yeah, they should never have given that back now that I think of it, but it's too late now.
Well, yeah, we're eating at home a lot. I guess that could be good for us, but...
As a family?
It's kind of boring.
Yeah.
But it saves money.
Do you have any awkward conversations at the family dinner table?
Awkward?
Sure, anything. Any arguments, anything come up? Or do you generally keep that to a minimum?
Yeah, I think we typically lately can be keeping it to a minimum. And when you're really stuck in, you know, when you can't leave the house or except under exigent circumstances, you have to be careful not to create you don't want to create a poisoned atmosphere where there's a lot of negative feeling. And like, so I try not to get into arguments with my wife about stuff that I don't need to get into arguments with her about.
That's very smart. Yes.
Yeah.
Tank, how many people do you come in contact with on a weekly basis, or are you really minimizing your contact?
I'm really minimized right now.
It's what?
Minimized?
I'm really minimized right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I mean, you don't go near anybody. You don't touch anybody. You just...
Well,
you don't
pretty even, much.
You're not in the presence of anyone.
I mean, you're just not within... You probably talk to people a little when you go outside, but... Right, but you don't have any close interaction.
Yeah, that's the same with me.
Yeah.
It's just weird.
Yeah, like I don't... I'd be okay, other than you. Yeah. And you better be... Boy, you better not be carrying anything, motherfucker.
Oh. Well, I don't have a camera on you either.
Uh-oh.
You could be taking runs down to the beach and... I don't know.
Oh, yeah, speaking of the beach, and I was going to tell you about this, yeah, another thing to be horrified about, although I think it's ridiculous, but that being said, the Scripps Oceanic Institute, some big science research thing out here in California, have you heard of it, Chab Dog?
Scripps Institute, yeah.
That's them. So some lady scientist there.
Spelling Bee.
Spelling Bee, oh, yeah. Yeah, that's them. So some lady scientist over there says that this could be released in runoff. That goes down to the ocean, and then it could
in the mist.
Well, you know, mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, it could just be carried off. You know, like a lot of stuff's carried off when there's a storm. You know, after rain and stuff, like we're going to have today. Mm. So it's carried out of the ocean, and then in the ocean it gets aerosoled because you know the waves are crashing. And she's saying this virus could just be blown across, and in fact, so she said the ocean be the last place. Because surfers can't be in the water, and the ocean be the last thing I'd be in.
But then you would have expected a lot of people to be getting sick.
Well, that's what I'm thinking. That, geez.
I mean, just the sheer numbers of people that would come.
If that was the case, the oceans would have killed us centuries ago. There's no way that can be true.
I
appreciate this woman has a theory, and you know, all scientists have a theory. But just the thought of that, yeah. There's Tank. Can you think of an instance where something airborne from the ocean was killing people or making them sick? I can't think of any.
These days, anything is possible.
Yeah, but let's say what's really probable. You know, things that have never happened. I mean, if we're going to start experiencing things that have never happened before, well, then all bets are off. But that very seldom happens even in human history. I'm trying to think of, Chabdok, can you tell me, or both of you, I'll put it out there. Think of an example where something happened and it was unique, the first time ever occurring, and it just... Either killed a lot of people or... Yeah, and it killed a lot of people.
I don't know.
Maybe an atomic bomb?
Yeah.
Which we used twice. They killed people twice.
I mean, the ocean can kill a lot of fish if it's not right.
Yeah.
But I never heard of the mist
forever. Yeah.
From the ocean doing anything.
I've never seen it making anyone
sick. A tsunami.
Yeah, that 84 tsunami was, or no, 94, no, 2004. That one over there in Asia, okay.
Yeah.
But that didn't break down society in the world. So it was a sort of a localized thing. But yeah, okay, there's I guess you got to get, yeah, to get up to, we got to start thinking of that level of just sudden and unanticipated destruction. Yeah, I guess you say like an earthquake would be, you know, the people who died in the quakes we've had here.
Well, like when we dropped, when we did what we did to Japan in World War II, the atomic bomb.
Yeah, that was pretty quick and sudden. You know, one day we didn't have the ability to kill 100,000 people in one instant, and the next day we did, and we put it in place, and bang, that was Hiroshima.
Mm-hmm.
But boy, that wouldn't have worked either way. I mean, they were training children to sharpen sticks and use them against the Americans when they came to the island. It would have been a mess. We saved so many lives. You know, anyway, you talk about how that was the wrong thing to do is just wrong talk. That's just a bad take.
Yeah.
Hey, Frank, you're not one of these weak-kneed willies that think we were too hard on the Japanese by using A-bombs. Where are you?
Nope.
But you know these people I'm talking about that come up with that angle.
Of course.
Revisionist history.
Okay. Well, that was a long time ago.
It was the same with interning the Japanese here on the West Coast. And believe me, I'm not...
You know,
it's horrible.
Barack Obama wanted to formally apologize for the nuking of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And basically, someone took him out of it, said, yeah, you'd be insulting the Japanese by apologizing.
Yeah, that's right. Among other things. Yeah, that would have been a bad move. We can't apologize for taking steps in a war.
Yeah,
they
almost did apologize, and it was like,
they didn't apologize.
You ate the finally took and said, you did this something you don't do.
Pearl Harbor.
But he really wanted to apologize.
And the Japanese war camps were the worst.
Oh, yeah.
They made the German war camps look like a walk in the park.
Yeah, the death march from Bataan.
Did you see the movie?
With our soldiers? Yeah, no, we're not apologizing for shit.
There was
sorry.
A USC runner, a famous USC runner that was imprisoned there and survived it, but it was, they did a movie about it.
Yeah, that rings a bell now.
Good movie.
He's a pilot, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I remember that story. I don't remember the name of the movie, but or the book. It's a famous book.
Yeah, I can't remember. It's a good actor that's in it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well,
okay. So Tank, your prediction is society as we know it will stop somewhere in June. So we won't even make the 4th. That's your prediction.
No, when the weather starts getting warmer, that's when things are going to start going nuts.
So why? I think the disease doesn't do as well in hot weather.
Yeah, we don't know.
But the lockdowns remain, and that's when people go nuts.
We've never seen this in a summer.
I mean, that's what I've heard, and
yeah, well, they're likening it to other.
Trump mentioned it, and I did kind of verify that this thing doesn't survive well in hot temperatures.
Well, that's what the current thinking is. That is
maybe that's
true.
Part of why Africa is so not affected by this.
They're underreporting. You know how many Chinese are
Africa's
in Africa?
Underreporting.
Oh hell, yeah! I do not trust the numbers in Africa.
You know why Africa is not getting hit by this?
Why?
Malaria.
What, they take a lot of anti-malaria drugs?
Yes.
The hydrochloroquine?
Yeah, the one they won't allow anyone to take.
Well, yeah. Not in New York State anyway, but will New Jersey let you take it?
Well, the FDA said you could take it.
I know, but New York State said that you can't.
Well, Cuomo. Fuck them. What do
well,
they
know?
I know.
It's Governor Cuomo, man.
But that's
no
not really.
Man.
I don't see how they can't. They can't preempt the. Or supersede the FDA. That's just a.
You challenge them in court.
Illegal.
You know.
It's not.
Three
it's
months
not
later,
correct.
I might get it figured.
It's called preemption.
This is Palm Sunday, by the way.
Yeah. Oh,
it would have been anyway.
I think the first day of Passover is.
Yes.
Is it today?
That's.
Or is it tonight? Does it start tonight?
We need to look that up.
Yeah. I'll have to go buy some gefilte fish. I'll have to wait online at Trader Joe's and go buy some gefilte fish.
That'd be worth it.
Yes.
So Tank, when society breaks down, what do you think we'll see missing first? Will the internet work? Will Twitter still work?
Well, toilet paper.
Will we be tweeting about it?
Toilet paper's missing.
No, but
we'll shut everything down. We'll be, and they'll be giving us a book You'll see after hugging the Motorcycle Diaries.
Oh, motorcycle. It won't be her red book is the Motorcycle Diaries.
Oh, the Motorcycle Diaries, yes. Gotta love the Motorcycle Diaries. Che Guevara, right?
Do you think she's going to emerge, she or her people, the Justice Democrats, will emerge as the de facto leaders of the United States, or what's left of it? Or the neighborhood of Brooklyn, or Queens?
And then the new national anthem will be a simple gift.
It'll be what now?
It's simple. It's a gift to me. It's a gift to have nothing but what's provided for me. I work hard for my labor, and each and every dime goes to my neighbor.
Dance them, whoever you
what
may
song
be.
Was that?
I am the Lord of the Dance, said he. It's
no, Simple Gift.
Oh, Simple Gift. Okay, well, it sounds like the tune of two. An old Catholic hymn, but either way. Well, yeah. I'd rather.
We don't need anything but our hopes and our labor now. We're grateful for the leadership and of now, and we don't need anything right now.
I'm impressed at how you're able to do all that impromptu.
Tank, are you doing anything for your blog? Like, do you ever do any? Do you ever make any new material these days?
Oh, he's been getting caught up in a lot of stuff.
I got one more hot dog review coming up. Mm-hmm. I'm doing a card opening soon.
A card open, like a card show or card card store?
Opening baseball pack.
Baseball pack, yeah.
Oh, I see. Okay. But yes, so the hot dog review, do you go to the...
Yes!
What was that, Tank?
I hope he's okay.
Oh, I can still hear him noise in the background.
I'm just so sick of this.
What happened? Oh, you're
running out of peeps. Tank did a killer review on peeps. You know what a peep is?
No.
Oh, it's it's an Easter candy. And it's like a little bird, and it's just made of marshmallow. It's like it's made of weird sugar.
It could be a bird, or it could be a bunny.
Or
sometimes
bunny.
A bunny. So.
Yeah, a bunny. Yeah.
Is it chocolate covered?
No, it's more like a marshmallow.
No, it's
sugar
marshmallow.
Yeah, but
sugar marshmallow.
But this time he had root beer flavored Peeps, which I've never heard of before. Because Peeps are the grossest thing on the planet. But I bet you, and you gave it a big, you gave it a high score rating. You like to say.
Yeah, well, the regular Peeps aren't that good, yeah.
They're not.
They're just sugar-covered marshmallows.
Yeah.
But a root beer-covered marshmallow, a root beer-flavored marshmallow is really nice, huh?
Yeah, what do you think of that, Tank?
You liked it?
Eat in the mouth, you don't deserve anything at all. Because it's going to become the first Soviet state.
But there is no Soviet state. It's gone. Where, I mean, this is the comeback?
Well, it's going to be the Soviet States of America or the People's Republic of America.
People's Republic.
I don't know what the name will be, but China, it will be something like that.
Yeah, China comes out and says, we're the only country in the world
People's
that was able
Republic
to really take
of
care
New
of this.
Jersey.
So we're taking over the rest of the world. You're working for us now. Yeah, this is the China takeover.
And Hillary Clinton will both be there going, we're the hero! And
maybe you should
make him mad with that fucking goddamn.
Well, he's born in Montana.
Montana.
But he was raised in New Jersey.
I just, he might be happier in a more conservative state.
Yeah, that has dawned on me. But Tank, don't you think he'd be happier living in a more conservative state?
They're gone. It's all gone. They're going to merge the state soon. There's going to be 13 regions. The middle of the country is going to be called Heartland.
Yeah, what's that? Is that from, are you taking this from Heartland itself, or is this from another dystopian future story?
It's what's happening. They're going to merge all the states. Okay. But, like, for example, all the middle states will be one regional area called Heartland.
Yeah. Yeah, that's where we'll build the star base. Will be built there. Mm-hmm. Building starships in Iowa. This is the coastal.
And everyone will have to have the woodsman call the who has a farm out there. They'll be like the farms that they had like in Ukraine in 1933.
Oh, a collective. Agricultural collective?
Yeah, cultural collective.
Oh, well, that's forced labor, man. I mean, you're like your job now, whatever you're doing, you're a dentist. No, now you're a farm laborer, and you will go work at our collective,
yep.
And we have a bunk bed for you. And you will mate with who we choose you to mate with, if you mate at all.
Yep, that's going to happen within the next 5 years.
Tank, you can't be serious.
Yeah, that's coming.
It's a red scare.
In 5 years.
It's definitely a red scare.
But who's going to allow this? You know, you wouldn't allow this. I won't allow this. Brandon certainly wouldn't allow this. Who in their right minds would allow this to happen?
Well, there might be a civil war in between, but yeah.
Well, but people with these ideas wouldn't win such a civil war. How would people who push these ideas win a civil war?
They'll have the military. The military will crush everyone. The media will take away everyone's guns. The media will be out there.
You think the media would side with AOC the military? The military is way more powerful than AOC
Bernie Sanders or Biden get control and
or Hillary Clinton
Biden's running mate, probably Hillary Clinton.
Uh-huh.
It will be revenge time.
Yeah, but if that ever happened, you know what would happen. One of the House of the Senate or some piece of that would still be Republican.
This is going to be the biggest blue wave ever.
Yeah, if we allow mail-in voting, there's a chance for voter fraud that's going to cause that.
Uh-huh. I don't know, Frank. You're starting to sound a little like Debbie Downer.
You know, you are sounding a little bit like Debbie.
Yeah, I think speaking of that, we're going to go to
only because this makes
we're going to go to a Debbie Downer.
This is a segue.
Yeah,
because this is kind of funny.
if you don't start cheering up, I'm not going to invite you to Thanksgiving.
Well, that's worth it. Like Debbie Downer.
Know, most of all, I'm just thankful for being home for the holidays.
You know, I'm just thankful that I met Michelle this year. And now I get to spend Thanksgiving with your family. You know, I'm really looking forward to getting to know you guys.
Yeah. Oh, I'm thankful that someone in this family has a date. I was going to bring a guy I met on Match.com, but after we exchanged photos, I never heard from him again.
You're enjoying your day, everything's going your way, and along comes Debbie Downer. Always there to tell you about a new disease, a car accident or killer bees. We beg her to spare you, Debbie, please, but you can't stop Debbie Downer.
Hey, can you pass some of that turkey?
Oh, it looks juicy.
I'm sorry, I thought it was all mine.
Boy, the traffic was a disaster coming up, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Nothing compared to the disaster the Chinese are going through. What? They're still digging out from typhoon season, just in time for the bird flu to take even more lives.
Bird flu, right?
Who wants some more wine?
I'd love some.
Okay.
Hey, do you guys think the Pilgrims brought a bottle of Pinot Grigio to the first Thanksgiving?
I'll tell you what the Pilgrims did bring. Smallpox. Killed scores of Native Americans, ravaging their population. And that was before we got around to shattering their spirit.
Sweetheart, you look cute in that tie.
Hey, you should see me in my underwear.
Did you guys get tested? What?
Terrible.
Well, you know, you think you know someone, then you see that Oprah about living on the down low.
I'd like to propose a toast.
All right. Here
okay. I'd like to welcome Mark. We're very happy to be here. Also, like Portland, us all to remember Grandma. I'm sure she's looking down on us and smiling.
So he plays a
I hope it's the version of her before she was in the grips of dementia.
Otherwise, she'd just be confused.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure your grandma was a great lady and really loved, you know, most of you.
Most of you. Hey,
could you pass the stuffing?
Sure. Debbie, stuffing?
Hey, Frank, did you cook this in the bird?
Yeah, soaks up all the juices.
Also soaks up an array of harmful bacteria, creating a breeding ground for foodborne illnesses.
Just like the fast food place. That's
such good. Hey, can I say something? I just want to say that I've never been happier than I am right now, and I never want this feeling to end, so...
Oh. Oh, my God, Mark!
Michelle, will you marry me?
Oh, that's my God, of course, yes! Yeah. Yeah.
Got a Amy Poehler.
Michelle, let us see the ring.
Oh, it's beautiful, Mark. This must Parks have cost you leg. A fortune.
Hey, just like they say, 2 months' salary.
Did you factor in the loss of life at the hands of the African diamond industry?
You know what, Debbie? I've known you for less than a day, but I've kind of had it with you. I mean, I never said a word when we were watching the parade and you told me everything I could ever wish to know about Al-Qaeda, or when the Garfield float came by and you made that speech about feline AIDS.
It's the number one killer of domestic cats.
Meow, meow.
And that's very, very sad, but I don't want to talk about it during my marriage proposal.
Come on, Mark. We're going to go eat in the TV room.
Excuse me.
Guess who's got eczema?
Yeah. And then the turkey walks off.
Oh,
the
that's
table
right.
Too.
The turkey walks off. Okay.
Here the turkey.
Well, I guess it's just you and me, Mr. Turkey.
She's so bad. She's scared. No, you can't stop turkey. Yeah.
All right.
Well,
Chab Dog, you got to cut us all some slack here, because we all can feel a little Debbie Downer at times.
Oh, I know. I have those moments just like Frank does, and then the whole trick is to have more you know, break it up with happy times, even if you're deluding yourself.
What's next? You have to be happy.
No, you got to make yourself happy. That's all. You got to find something on TV that you want to watch, or on the computer. Something to.
You mean fucking commercials every 5 minutes?
I listen to music. That's the way I get away from it. What do you do?
My advice to you.
Drink heavily?
Start drinking heavily.
Yes, vodka and tequila.
Oh, see, I don't like alcohol that much, so I got to have a different vice. And you know what that is, but... Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a lot of that, too.
And then, I don't know. If you can
what the hell is supposed to do, you moron?
I can see if you're not working, you know, and it's...
Well, my business is severely curtailed right now. I mean, it's only lately, now that they have the CARE Act out and we have some information on it. Yeah, I'm spending time now pouring over that.
Right.
To be able to go back to my business owners and have some applicable solutions.
Well, there's the Paychecks Protection.
There's that. You can defer paying payroll tax until for the rest of the year, basically. That's a huge thing.
Can anybody do that?
Any business, yes.
How do you do that?
I'll tell you the forms to use on Monday. Okay.
Yeah, because I know there's that paycheck protection loan.
Yeah, so yeah. There's that, and then if you're a business, so this would be like, for instance, your law firm.
Mm-hmm.
If you can show a document, say drop in revenue coming in, that's attributed, and that'll just automatically be attributed to this, then you can get one of these forgivable loans for that amount.
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
So and other programs as well.
That might be the paycheck protection thing.
Yeah, that might encompass part of that.
And so there's Jack, definitely.
Is the courthouse paying you through this so far?
For now.
Yeah.
So no.
Well, that's good.
Has there been any rumor of a furlough coming, to your knowledge?
Probably.
He's an essential service, though. I mean,
well, so's that black bailiff lady too.
The courts have been interrupted, but they're not done. Yeah. So, but for the people that don't have any work and they're stuck in the house, I mean, that's just cataclysmic. But at least they're not sick. Hopefully, you're not sick.
Well, but they're out spreading it right now. Did you see the president's news conference yesterday, Tank?
I saw part of it.
You saw part of it, and I got part of it too, but just towards the end. A friend of ours, Kathy, my girlfriend, was saying that she heard some of the earlier part of it and was a little alarmed by some of the notions there.
Uh huh.
Did either of you hear anything particularly alarming?
I don't remember anything too.
It's the same thing I see every day. It's just depressing. Depressing is all fuck.
Just them are kind of arguing about whether they had enough ventilators or whether the states were getting what they should get. And
yeah, that's getting redundant now.
Yeah, but and
now
I
he did meet with the with
talking about the curves.
Whose sports owners did he meet with yesterday? He talked to, was it baseball or NFL?
Commissioners.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, it's 10 o'clock, so we can't.
Oh, my.
We hit 10 o'clock, so we're going to go to our break.
Probably got a new commercial.
And we're going to play a new fall line commercial. And you're welcome to stay on, Frank. We're going to probably have Brian on, and Cammy might be calling in.
I think we have. Yeah, Cammy. Call in. Hit on Cammy.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Well, we're going to go to our break. We'll be back in 5-10 minutes. Okay? Stay tuned.
Hey, thank you, Tank.
Thanks for calling in, Frank.
On the Chab Dog Sports Talk Radio Show.
Hang in there.
Hitting our break right here, starting with our Defy Light.
Yes, the new ad. This is
here's the
ad.
New ad. Finally, check
this
out. You're going to like this.
JR, you know what you're doing.
We're told that greatness is exceptional, when it should be expected. You choose every day to live your life intentionally, without apology for how bright your light may shine. So go be great. Go be brilliant. Go be you. Go defy life. The Defy Life movement is one that speaks to each of us in its own way. Defy Life gear speaks to us all by reminding us that one size does not fit all. Visit DefyLifeGear.com to get fitted for greatness.
The Law Office of Brandon S. Chabner, serving clients in Southern California with transactional legal services since 2007. We handle general corporate, outside counsel type work, drafting and negotiating a wide variety of business and commercial contracts, including non-disclosure agreements, independent contractor agreements, and employment agreements. Our experience includes working with public and private companies and involves a broad range of industries, including healthcare, consumer products, real estate, and high technology. Mr. Chabner has over 20 years of legal experience, having worked for some larger national firms and serving as general counsel for a multi-million dollar private company here in Southern California before starting his own legal practice. His educational credentials include a law degree from UCLA, where he was on law review, undergraduate degree at Yale, where he graduated magna cum laude, and an MBA from Harvard Business School. Other areas of focus for Chabner Law include press release and business plan editing, pre-litigation matters, and debt and mortgage resolution work. You can contact us at 310-698-0740 and at dchabner@chabnerlaw.com.
Like Chab Dog said, he was 100% right.
He can take all comers.
Fine, man.
Oh, you ain't scared of a little speed, are you, man?
Oh, you got some speed, man?
Huh? Oh, speed? No, I don't got no speed, man. Hey, you know what I do got, though, man? I got a joint, man.
Oh, wow. Yeah. All right.
Hey, come on. Light it up. Let's get Chinese eyes, man.
What kind of joint is this, man?
Oh, it's a heavy-duty joint, man.
It looks like a toothpick, man.
No, it's not a toothpick, man.
No, hey, it is a toothpick, man.
Oh, man, it's just... It is a toothpick. I must have got it in the other pocket, man. Hold on, man. I got the little shit right here, man. Oh, that's my dick. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, there you go, man. Let that sucker up, man. We'll go to the moon.
Jeez, I hope your dick's bigger than this, man.
Hey, man, you wanna get out and walk, man?
Hey, you wanna get high, man?
This howdy doody got wooden balls, man.
I got a joint here, man. I've been saving for a special occasion.
Play on fire, though.
Hey, I hope the drums don't mess up your upholstery, man.
Nah, I'm in a band too, man.
Oh, are you?
Yeah, I'm a lead singer, man.
Ah, oh, that's it.
Yeah, we play everything from like Santana to El Chicano, man. You know, like everything. Hey, I'm just a love machine. And I don't work for nobody but you. I'm just a love machine. And I don't work for nobody but you. Well, when my temperature rise, and then I go for her thighs. And then I say, guacamole in my juice. Guacamole in my juice. Hijo de la chinga. Is that a joint, man? Goddamn, looks like a quarter pounder, man. Led Zeppelin.
Hey, be careful with that shit, man.
Is it heavy stuff, man? Will it blow me away?
Put your seatbelt on, man. I'll tell you that much.
I've been smoking since I was born, man. I could smoke anything, man. You know, like I smoked that Michoacan, man, Acapulco Gold, man. I even smoked that tight stick, you know?
Tight stick?
Yeah, you know, that stuff is tied to a stick, you know?
Tight stick.
Yeah, that didn't even do nothing to me, man. I could probably smoke this whole joint, man, and still walk away, man. Wouldn't be no problem at all, man.
Talk it out, man.
Do nothing to me.
Kind of grabs you by the boo-boo, don't it?
Hey, man.
What?
What? Oh, it was in this shit, man.
Mostly Maui Waui, man.
Yeah?
But it's got some Labrador in it.
What's Labrador?
It's dog shit.
What?
Yeah, my dog ate my stash, man. Had it on the table and the little motherfucker ate it, man.
Yeah.
It's so cloudy.
So I had to follow him around the little baggie for 3 days before I got it back. Really blew the dog's mind.
You mean we're smoking dog shit, man?
It's
a heavy duty. Hello, Brian.
Hello, Brian.
Hey, how you doing?
We're just finishing up our break with this Cheech and Chong, you know? Clip.
Damn, I wonder what Great Dane tastes like, man. Ah, man.
Now the best part's
That's
coming
some
up.
Heavy shit, man.
Look how slowly they're moving. Can you imagine being in a car like that?
Hey, man. Am I driving okay?
I think we're parked, man.
You ever have that happen to you?
Damn, I was in that shit, man. I never had no dope like that before in my life, that man. That's the heaviest shit I ever smoked, man. I mean, I smoked a lot of stuff before,
behind
man.
A parked
but
car,
man. That's heavy shit.
5 minutes.
You
abandoned.
Okay?
It was an abandoned car.
Wow.
The guy didn't even realize
Listen,
it.
Man.
I can't breathe, man.
I sat at a driving light for quite a while sometimes.
Hey,
well, yeah, because you get mesmerized by the light.
Oh,
light, that bright light.
I never smoked no shit like that before.
Take these.
What?
Take these. This will mellow you up, man.
What is this, man?
I'm just taking
mellow yellows.
Hey, don't take those, man.
What?
I almost gave you the wrong shit.
Hey, man, I already took them, man.
Hey, what do you mean?
Wow, man. Hey, what was that shit, man?
You just ate the most acid I've ever seen anybody eat in my life.
Hey, man, I never had no acid before, man.
Jeez, I hope you're not busy for about a month.
Shit, I'm gonna die, man. That stuff's gonna make me die, man.
Man, no, that's good acid.
Hey, man,
that's
I never had it before, man. That's gonna make me die. What's this gonna make me freak out, man? Man. I seen those guys walk around my neighborhood had too many acid, man. The head looked like a pumpkin,
man.
Like that,
man. Relax,
like,
mellow out, man. Now just go, oh.
What?
Do it, oh. Man. Oh. Oh.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Mellow.
Oh, man.
Mellow. Yeah. You better now, man?
Yeah.
You mellow?
Yeah.
Feel all right, huh?
No! What are you doing, man?
Sometimes that helps.
Sometimes.
Hey, listen, can we get off this street, man? Listen, we're parked in the bad spot.
Oh, this is great. Cop
just went by, man.
Oh,
we missed that part, but the cop pulls up next to him. Was that back? Yeah, we're back. We've got the second hour to deal with here, and
on the
Chab Dog Sports Talk.
It never gets old, does it?
Well, it was just, you know,
that's probably the 115th time
I think watching
I've
that movie, it. Just kind of I got a contact high from that, you know.
Absolutely.
Chab Dog Sports Talk hour 2. You missed Frank Fleming, who I guess couldn't take it anymore. He vented for about 55 minutes about how bad his life is
and made some very grim predictions
yeah.
in terms of what the next few months.
I caught some snippets of it now.
Yeah, boy.
So I hope you're a little more upbeat, Brian, and I did come armed with some baseball trivia, so we can definitely go over that, okay? But Brian is he's kind of a sports numbers guy like me.
Yes, I noticed that. You two can really talk it up. It's actually fun to hear.
Yeah, we definitely have a common interest there, and so I enjoy the back and forth, the banter. I was trying to, you know, so I'll go jump right into it. I was trying to find some other players that, you know, were kind of classic snubs. And it's really unfortunate when, you know, you have a guy like, okay, so I looked at Al Oliver again because I'm a Pirates fan. And you know about him, right? He played center field for the Pirates, outfield for the Pirates. And he was with the Expos and the Texas Rangers in his last year. 17 or 18 years. He was in the top 25 for the most valuable player voting 8 times. So it was almost half his career. That's incredible. And
yeah.
You know, he was a 3-time silver slugger, whatever that means. Do you know what that means?
That's your leading hitter at that position.
Ah. That's excellent. Yeah. Okay.
Who was Harold Baines had won multiple of those as a DH.
Oh well, I'll give him credit for that. I mean, I think you got to give him credit. It's a position, DH.
Oh yeah, definitely. And he finally made it. He was one that I was on the borderline.
Yeah. Oh,
when
real,
he made
real
it,
borderline.
When he made it, it made guys like Al Oliver now look, you know, a lot
right.
more.
I mean, if you
know,
think
eligible.
About what Al Oliver did and compare it, I think Harold Baines, yeah, maybe he got more hits. He kind of outlasted a lot of people. But Al Oliver was in there for 17 years. Like I said, he won a 7-time All-Star, almost half his career as an All-Star. One batting title, one World Series championship, a good fielder, and then the numbers, 2743 hits, .303 average, 529 doubles, 219 homers, 77 triples. I think he's got to be in there. It's just not right, in my opinion.
Yeah, yeah. I had posted that up because, it was not too long ago, his birthday came up, I guess. You know, there's a guy that keeps posting birthdays every day on my Sports Rock page. But he, I look up the guys, try to put a little blurb every time a famous or, well, any baseball player comes up. And I pointed out all those stats and everything and how he should be in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah. So that's a classic snub. Then going back in time, I picked up two other guys. And these were interesting stories because they were both deaf. And one was deaf mute. His name was Dummy Hoy. He lived to be 99 years old, by the way. And he made this funny sound in the outfield because nobody could communicate with him any other way. He kind of... Oh, somebody calling? Okay. Yeah, well, we'll get Cammy on. And so he was one that should have made it. His numbers were 2,000 hits, .288 average, 600 stolen bases. And then there was this other guy, Pete Browning. Oh, I love this guy. He was called the Gladiator. He hit .341 in 13 years. Only had 1,600 hits. But that was because of his, I think, limited time. But he had three batting titles, and he had a 400 average season. And he was deaf.
Yeah, you got me looking up him. I know the name from the past because the batting titles.
Yeah.
And, you know, his name kept popping up back then. But, yeah, story on him. Maybe the first guy to actually have bats made for him.
Right. He had the Louisville Slugger made for him. They called it the Louisville Slugger because he was from Louisville. And the guy that made the bat for him was Helmerich. You know that name, Helmerich and Payne? It's the they're associated with the Louisville Slugger bat. And so the bat was customized for him. He broke out of a slump, and they called.
Hi there.
Oh, it's we got a
we have another guest on the Chab Dog Sports Talk Radio Show. Yeah,
a double X chromosome on finally.
How's it going?
Hi, Cammy.
Hi, Brandon.
Thank you for being.
How are you guys doing?
Thank you for being persistent.
We're healthy.
Oh, we're fine. I hope you can tell we're fine. I hope you're fine.
I am. I'm very healthy. I'm keeping healthy. Taking my zinc and vitamin C every day.
That's right. You were doing it before, so I mean, you're the healthiest
among us. Cammy has quite a routine.
Nothing changed. Yes.
Yeah, you're
very healthy routine.
One of the healthier people we've ever met. Mm-hmm. And as opposed to me,
I'm sure there's people healthier though.
And we got Brian on the line. Brian Keller, who's a contributor to the show, and he has his own site. Have you met him?
I have not met him. No.
Sports Rock.
He's a great guy.
Shut up.
Say hello to Cammy for me. Cammy's one of our. She's a big friend of mine. And
hello, Cammy.
Yeah.
Hi, Brian.
Is it Cammy? Hi.
Cammy,
K-A-M-M-Y.
Hi.
All right.
Yeah.
And, I'm just hanging out in my shelter here.
Oh, I know, right? A quarantine shelter. Oh,
yep.
My gosh.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, Cammy knows all about rationing and being able to corner the market on things. She did a new video which she can talk about, which is how you save toilet paper. Is that right?
How I save toilet paper, right? Yes.
Are you the
I
one?
I even wore a dress.
Oh, well, very look special. At, look at that too. Dress. It's a beautiful white
folks.
Dress.
I hope you're all healthy and well right now, considering this coronavirus going around. I am wearing a dress made of toilet paper.
Turn around. There you go.
You're probably wondering, why would I waste toilet paper on a dress, especially at this time when there's a toilet paper shortage? First of all, I want to say, it's been nearly 3 weeks since the toilet paper shelves have been bare. I'm not sure why everyone thinks they need to buy all this toilet paper and not leave any for anyone else. So instead of fighting for toilet paper in the grocery stores, because that doesn't look good, I choose to make it last and make it look good. Believe it or not, I don't like wasting toilet paper. So if I have to pee, I tear off two squares and then I wipe. Ooh. If I have to poo.
That's
sexy.
Two squares.
Then I tear off.
That's it?
Three squares.
Three.
And then I wipe. That's and if great. I blow my nose, one square. And then I blow. If by any chance I run out
or
of toilet
going
paper,
to your elbow, right?
I just jump in the shower and wash off. And so should you. In the meantime, while I'm homebound for the next 30 days, I'll enjoy wearing my cute little mini dress made of whatever toilet paper I can get my hands on. Honestly, with all these hot flashes I'm getting all day long, who needs clothes anyway? Stop hoarding toilet paper!
All right, that's a real public service message.
Yeah, with a hard finish.
The end
hard
was
finish.
Good. Stop hoarding toilet
stop
paper.
Stop hoarding toilet paper.
Stop, they're still hoarding.
I know. Idiots.
Yeah. Have you guys been able to buy any toilet paper?
You know, I think I've seen some coming into the house in dribs and drabs, and it's not the ones we usually. I usually use Charmin, but now it's like Northern or something, and we're being forced to use other brands.
Yeah, about 3 weeks ago, when I was normally running out of toilet paper, I managed to.
Oh, you hoarded a bunch?
No, I just got my hands. I had to buy a 6-roll pack instead of a 4-roll pack, which is what I usually buy. So I got, 6 rolls, so I'm fine. I'm fine for another month.
Oh.
Or two.
Yeah, I picked up one of those. I think it was like 24s about 3 weeks ago or so. But it's gotten down to the last two. And in the meantime, I did get lucky. I was at a store, just had a couple little things, and surprised to see about four packs on the shelf. So I just grabbed them. Well, you can only get one, so I grabbed one of those.
Yeah, the only limit to one. It used to be three, now it's one. But you know what? They let the seniors go in early, like an hour earlier than everyone else, so they get to grab all the toilet paper.
Well, that's perfect.
Yeah, Cammy,
you're... The seniors are hoarding the toilet paper, then they're going to sell it back to us in a seniors black market, and they'll use that to pay for their drugs.
But, Cammy, you're a master of... you can do disguises and stuff.
Oh, very well.
I saw that picture of you on Facebook when you were 100 years old, by the way. It still looks very good.
Isn't that beautiful? Yeah. Oh,
I
hope I look like that at 100.
I'm not embarrassed to admit that I'd, if you look like that at 100, I'd tap that.
And you didn't, did you see mine?
I wouldn't tap yours.
You wouldn't tap mine? Well, when I did it, it put me, made me look like Hulk Hogan or something at 100.
I know, right?
I know. Well,
really wouldn't tap it. I'll
take it.
Yeah. Well, maybe we'll get there. But you could, in the meantime, you could get disguised as, try to dress up as a 70-year-old and try to get in there.
Yeah,
that might be a good skit.
Yeah, I need to write some more skits for sure.
Yeah.
I think people need to laugh more nowadays, you know?
Yes.
But
it's
been
quite depressing for a lot of people.
I don't know how you do that, though. You know, you just, because you don't have a 70-year-old's body, that's for sure.
You'd have to wear like a big baggy dress or something.
You'd have to really do some creative stuff.
Like a burka.
All right. Yeah, true.
Speaking of which, veils now. Veils, face masks are coming into fashion. Like we are wearing burkas. Which is kind of ironic.
Yeah, that's true. Now it's whatever you can wrap around your face. They don't care. Even though they say it doesn't really, prevent the spread of germs, but it's better than nothing.
Masks are just so sinister, though,
They are. You usually...
So many...
We're accustomed to people wearing them when they're holding up a train.
Yeah, or killing somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
You know?
Well, they're concealing their identity for... Yeah, on board.
Bank robberies, though. Bank robberies are classic.
Kidnappings.
We could really go, you could do something with this if you put you thought about it.
What, funny bank?
Make
I
a
could.
Good make a good TV series or something.
Mm-hmm. A TV series. Yeah, it's gonna last, be a multi-year series, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm open for suggestions.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think? Do you think right now people are still living in, you know, just, I mean, I'll speak for myself. I think many people are like myself, just kind of living in illusion right now, just thinking, oh, this is all going to pass, and just, you know, taking it a day at a time, you know, the old cliche.
Mm-hmm.
And just
right.
Trying to pretend a way through it.
So
humor's good.
Oh.
And humor's definitely good for that. And then for those who are despondent,
it's a must to the
doc. Yeah.
Keep your mind off of what's going on. Just stop watching the TV for a while and, mm-hmm. you know, look at some comedy or write some comedy.
Well, things that we don't seem to have any control over anymore.
I watched the news for like an hour yesterday.
Exactly.
And that was really all I could take. I mean.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. For sure.
Just can't.
We're like in the twilight zone. We're in the twilight zone right now.
Yeah. And now to say something positive. Everyone knows Typhoid Mary, right? We all remember her. You know the story of Typhoid Mary?
Well, you can tell it to us again.
Okay. So she's in New Jersey, New York, actually. So it's
hit
tank back on the line.
Yeah.
So she was an asymptomatic carrier of typhus. And typhus was one of these diseases that also had a long incubation period, like the CCP virus here. I'm not going to call it China virus. I'm going to call it the CCP virus.
Be politically correct, please.
It is very clear. Yeah, it's the Chinese Communist Party virus. It's their virus. Anyway, it has a long incubation period. So just like, you know, like the flu, normal flu, it has incubation period about 24 hours. So you get it, bang, you know you're sick, and then you know you're communicable, and you can take steps and prevent transmission. This one,
right?
You don't know you're sick for a week or two. Sometimes
you may never know you're sick,
and sometimes you're just a carrier of it as well, and you never develop symptoms at all. But you're in the meantime, you're passing it on. Just like, and typhus was like that too. And yet we were over 100 years ago able to develop very effective ways to defeat typhus, which is an asymptomatic carried disease.
Mm-hmm.
And so it gives, I say, today with today's medical systems, with what we've got in play right now, we'll get this figured out.
Yeah, so we defeated it before, we'll defeat it again.
Right, so I take a lot of positivity from that, you know, in the next 90 days, not only will this be over, we'll have a solution, like, well, within 90 days, solutions will be put forth in terms of who needs to be distanced and what they need to be distanced for. And what activities are reasonably safe to carry on with, and we'll move past this.
Yes.
Well, yeah, I think so.
We already know that in New York they decided that rim jobs are not safe to carry on.
Oh, yeah, they had to, like, they had to tell people to stop, but they did have to tell people to ban rim jobs, yeah. The mayor, no less.
Did you know about that, Kevy?
No.
Yeah, this isn't a story from the Indian either. This is like for reals. Yeah, the mayor had to come out and make a statement in many of his statements mentioning, you know, like, knock off the rim drops, everybody.
In his eminent capacity as a police power chief, he can do things like that.
Well, I'd still rather have that than our sheriff was trying to cut off the gun sales, close the gun shops here, Mr. Villanueva.
Oh.
Hey, Brian, you catch wind of that? He's trying to shut down the gun stores.
What's that?
Alex Villanueva, the L.A. sheriff, was trying to shut down the gun stores, close them.
Saying
non-essential service.
I think, well, that caused a whole different slew of controversy, but I think the point was trying to make was, is it a necessary or essential business? It was his argument. And as far as I know, as far as I feel, you know, it really isn't. I mean, is it essential and for this situation? And people will come back, of course, you know, all the gun lovers and pro-Second Amendment. Mm-hmm. But I was sitting there going, well, you know what? I already have a couple of guns. I've got ammo. If you're one of those people, then you should have had guns and ammo before anything like this happened.
Yes.
So there's no excuse to go running out and stocking up on them now, you know.
And I'm willing to bet, Brian, that statistically, the guns that are last purchased are probably the first ones to be used. And as a law enforcement, and so in defense of the sheriff's action, And for law enforcement, that probably a lot of people think it's a good idea. It's like, yeah, you don't. They know statistically the last one's bought or the first one's used by especially people who are not used to carrying them and not used to using them. And will
exactly, them yeah, out. You're going to have a lot of first time
right.
self defense types.
Yes,
going to run out there. And,
yeah, yeah, I think they're going to save the world yeah. with their 45. Yeah.
Well, it's not to be confused with the police. That's for sure.
But then the police, yeah, it's the sheriff's departments that are usually put in harm's way with these newbie gun owners. So I get that, and that's very strong. But I also get the Second Amendment, and that's, you know, if you're a citizen and you haven't had a gun before and you really feel vulnerable, well, guess what? It's your right to get a firearm to protect yourself. So
I think people should learn how to use them and keep licensed, at least. That's my opinion.
Well, and that hasn't stopped. I mean, just because you can go out and buy one right now is you can go out and register, and if you haven't, then you have to get your, if you don't have a, haven't gone through a gun safety course, which is, I think, a three-day mm-hmm. program, you're going to have to get that certification before mm-hmm. you get a gun. So that hasn't changed.
Yeah, I think I saw a video on somebody posted about people who were buying guns at this guy's shop, but he was getting all mad at all the people because they were all mad and frustrated why they couldn't get their guns sooner. He was like, I just sell them. You
yeah.
have to wait for your background check, and you have to, you know, you can't just... You know, you're not going to get them any quicker, any
nope.
sooner.
That's right. That's right. And yeah. But that was in place already.
You have to make
There's
do.
Nothing new about
yeah.
that.
Make do with your Louisville Slugger.
That's right.
Instead of that.
Or your machete.
So,
flamethrower would be my weapon, second weapon of choice.
Cammy, exactly. I had a question for Cammy. Exactly how much toilet paper did that commercial require? That video required.
Let's see. I used probably almost less than half of the roll. Less than half.
Less than okay.
And then I unwrapped it and I rolled it back up and I've been using those sheets that I put around me, so mm-hmm. I'm not wasting toilet paper.
So I don't have to report you to the regulatory authorities for wasting toilet
Please
paper.
Please don't do that.
Yeah, I think there's a
no,
state board.
I'm using them. I am. Totally yeah. using them.
There's one for California, and this is so important. I think there's a local. There's an L.A. County board.
The one
for
good thing
paper.
About this is that no houses are getting rolled anymore.
Oh, that's
remember
all
that.
Yeah.
I know, right? I remember that. I remember toilet papering people's houses.
Yeah, TP bombing.
Yeah.
Years ago.
Uh-huh.
I think it happened in my house once. Yeah.
What were you people doing to the neighborhood that you deserved a TP?
I don't know. I had some unruly friends. I think they thought it was funny.
Well, okay, so it's someone pranking you.
It's really not funny at all when it rains and that happens.
Oh, no, because it's impossible.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Isn't that a nightmare?
Yeah. Well, the sprinklers come on in the morning.
Very much so.
Well, I want to know tell all of our listeners out there that this great piece, How I Save Toilet Paper, Stop Hoarding People, you can search it that way, or you can search
yeah.
it, go directly to Cammy. That's Kammy.
YouTube site, right?
Burnett, Burnett. And become one
That's
of her
right.
subscribers.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I'm going to, yeah.
That would be nice.
Yeah, become one. Yeah, but I just realized I wasn't subscribed myself. So hit that subscription button. Get her up to $239 now. And
there's
growing.
Also other things on there that are.
Oh, yeah, and check out her whole video collection there under
Kammy
Burnett.
Very funny stuff she did.
A lot of funny stuff there.
I heartily recommend the Sarah Palin video.
Oh.
that's what first, I first got hooked on your stuff was when I saw that.
Really? It was the sports girlfriends, the different types of sports girlfriends.
Oh, the sports one was the football video.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was my...
That's my most popular one.
Introduction
you know,
to
Cammy. That's the most viewed.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Guys really wish that would happen to them, but... It doesn't happen.
No, that's well, true. Yeah. And I'm not one of those girls either. I don't sit there and, please pay me attention.
You would let the guy watch his game.
Oh, I always, yeah, always.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean,
and more than that.
We don't mind if you're distracting us a little bit, but.
We want, yeah, certain kinds of distractions are.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And there's always halftime.
Well, yeah.
That's true.
That's what halftime is for,
That's
I think.
True. Yep. A little quickie and get back to the game.
And then there was another one you did that really got me excited. That was the pizza delivery one.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Pizza delivery, yeah. Yeah.
Did Did you see
that one?
That
was a crazy one. Yes, I wrote that. I thought, God, this was cleverly written, and I would like to be able to write with that cleverness with another type of video instead of just that, you know? Basically, it's not what you think. Things are not always what they seem.
Mm.
Yes.
That's what the video was
about. I'm just
about.
Trying to remember the way that ended. The delivery guy ran out of the place all scared. Is that what happened, and you didn't have to pay for it?
That's right. The whole idea was to freak him out so he'll just leave, and I can get free pizza.
I mean, do you want to play that, or can we play that?
Yeah, let's play that. It's and the title is How to Get Free Pizza, Pizza Boy Meets Cougar.
Brian, this have you heard this?
You got to hear this, Brian. It's one of my favorites.
Yeah.
Yes. Me
no,
either.
I haven't heard that.
Oh, well, too bad you can't see it. But
25
we can
minutes?
Hear it.
Great. See you then. Thank you. Bye. Oh my God. So cute.
There you go.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Can you come in for a minute? I have your money.
She's wearing a black nightie.
No, it's okay. I really have to go.
Just come in for a minute.
No, it's okay, really. No.
Come on.
No,
come
it's all right. No,
it's okay. I won't get you in trouble. I promise.
I mean, I guess.
Oh, it's a really nice house you have here.
Thank you. I had a date tonight. I got stood up. So.
Oh, no way. You got stood up?
I got stood up, so
oh my gosh,
he's by myself.
Oh, okay. Nice.
How late do you work tonight?
Oh, I work late shift. I really have to go. I don't have much time, really. I should go.
Stay a while.
I really can't. Like, I'll get fired.
I'll show you a good time.
No, it's okay. I really have to go.
This wasn't a very low contact delivery, was it?
Well, this guy just won't take no for an
answer. Hey. What are you doing?
It's from Beyond the Valley of the Ultra. Oh. There we go.
Love that music.
What is that? Oh, hell no.
Run like hell.
Hell no.
What about the pizza?
Just keep the pizza.
Keep the pizza.
Free pizza. Works every time.
What a twist. Ah. Wow. And you were able to get a tax deduction on that prop too, right? Right, Kelly?
I know it. Oh, yeah. I should have.
This is a very large, very taxes. Large deduction.
Very large deduction is right.
Yeah. Brian, you couldn't see it though. So did you understand everything that happened in there?
Yeah, I had an idea of what's going on.
Yeah. Well, you'll have to just look at it. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm yeah. seeing is believing.
Exactly.
But there's all kinds of fun stuff on her channel here.
And she does one with Trump where she's both Trump and Hillary. Is it Hillary?
No, Nancy Pelosi.
Nancy Pelosi.
Ripping up
Nancy Pelosi too, ripping paper.
The State of the Union.
Yeah.
Another one where you're you're talking a bit about Hillary. It's Hillary's fault.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, all kinds of great stuff.
So, this just goes on and on and on. And you're an actress, right?
Yes, I am. I was until this.
Mm-hmm. And commercials. Is that like commercials and TV series?
Yes, I've been on commercials and TV series. Yes, I have an IMDb. Mm-hmm. So if anybody wants to check me out, I'm on there. Mm-hmm. And it basically just trying to create my own content in the meantime, in between.
Mm.
Keep my creative juices flowing.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, comedy is therapy. It is totally therapy for me. And I think more people should, you know, go to comedy instead of, you know, drinking a bunch of alcohol or doing a bunch of drugs. You know, comedy is where it's at.
We could do all three, couldn't we?
Oh, sure you can.
That's even better.
Sure you can.
Now, for those who don't know Cammie, she's also done, she did a live show up in Hollywood. Was that about a year and a half ago now?
A live show?
Yeah, oh, the stand-up?
Yeah, you did your stand-up live show up in Hollywood.
Oh, yeah, the stand-up. Yes, definitely. Oh, yeah, I did. That's on there, too. That's on my channel.
Yeah.
That was my first one, and I've since rewritten that, and I planned on going to do some more stand-ups, and I will be doing that soon.
Awesome. We got to let us know.
Yeah. Yeah, I sure will.
Because that's like the, you know, it's the most challenging and yet the funniest stuff is like good stand-up.
It is most challenging. It's very nerve-wracking.
Yeah. But when it's, you know, I thought you did really, especially for your first time, you did extremely well. But just the whole notion of stand-up itself, I just find a great theater, great performance, it's just great entertainment.
Yeah. No, she's unique, I think. I don't find a lot of women very funny, but some of them I do like.
You're not really turned on to female comedians. Like,
no, but the one I like,
Aristocrats.
I like Cammie a lot. She's very good.
This one,
and then I like Melissa McCarthy.
Thank you.
I like
Melissa. Oh, I love her. Oh my gosh,
she's hilarious.
Mm-hmm.
She is. Yeah. Can you name anybody else that's really good? Any other? Like, I never liked Carol Burnett that much. She didn't do it.
Oh, you didn't like her?
No, I like Cammie Burnett a lot more than Carol Burnett.
It was a little different. Her comedy is very, very different.
Yeah, I kind of found it to be very predictable.
I'm trying to think. There's a woman, I think she's Mexican. I forgot her name. She's been on the, I think, Latino women's comedy with Snoop Dogg.
Oh, yeah?
Hmm.
Yeah.
Don't know her.
I don't remember her name. Yeah.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I think more comedians, funny comedians are mostly men.
Yeah, like Sarah Silverman, I don't really understand.
Why is that?
You're not a fan of Sarah Silverman.
I don't know.
She's not really funny.
She's not exciting. Just kind of more with her, I just want to get away from her.
Yeah.
She reminds me of some Jewish American princesses I used to know.
Yeah, exactly. Like she's a little too real to type. It's like... Yeah, exactly. Stereotypes are quick.
I hate
Jewish American princesses.
I hate Kathy Griffin. Okay.
Oh my God,
I just can't stand her.
Oh no,
I think everybody does.
I didn't like her before. I've never liked her.
I'm glad you didn't. No, nobody here liked her.
And then she did get some press this week. We all saw that she did find a way into the papers.
Yeah,
like claiming she was sick with something. It was probably Montezuma's revenge.
She has to get noticed somehow.
But she found a way
to
break
it. Yeah, she needs attention. She probably wants attention now.
Total attention.
And then, of course, you got Roseanne Barr.
Oh, poor Roseanne. I feel sorry. She got done. I feel sorry.
She was great. She was great in the beginning.
Yeah. She has her moments where I find it, you know, I find it enjoyable to watch her sometimes, but then when I really think about who I'm watching, I just can't get into it. I don't know what that means, but
well, a big strapping man like you can't imagine having sex
off
with her. Can you imagine her riding on top of you?
Oh God!
You see the look on his face now.
I think Wanda Sykes is funny.
Oh,
Wanda Sykes. Yeah, she's the guy. She's on
the black woman, right?
On with
Yeah,
well, yeah, she's a black woman, but aside from that, she's the one on Larry David.
Yeah, she's good. Yeah. She does a good job.
Yeah, definitely.
Blame the black man.
Tiffany Haddish is funny.
Yeah. No, there's some.
She has a good routine. I like her routine.
Yeah,
she's Jewish compatible.
There's a lot of good, comedic actresses.
Are there?
Yeah,
comedy
there
shows
some,
and stuff.
You'd have to think a little hard. I can start the conversation probably. I'm trying to. I know there are some. There's that one that.
Well, that guy we just saw, Amy Poehler. I'll throw Amy Poehler out there from Parks and Rec.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Amy Schumer's good.
Amy Schumer?
Did you ever see any Amy Schumer stuff?
Yeah, who's she?
She was in that movie Trainwreck that
of course.
We played.
Yeah.
Do you like that, Cammie?
I do. I did. It was really funny.
Yeah.
Yes, I like that.
There was this really funny scene once with her and John Cena, the wrestler or the fighter.
Yes. Yes.
Where he's having sex with her, and he's he's trying to get her into it, you know, and so he starts trying to talk dirty to her, but he does it in an
effeminate way that doesn't really do it for her. And then
homoerotic,
it gets him going harder.
And the harder he tries, the worse it gets.
It's a well written scene,
but she's very sarcastic and.
Well, could you imagine having sex with her?
Yeah, that's true.
Ew, why do you keep putting me on the spot?
Oh, it's your show.
What about you, Eric?
Yeah, what about you?
No.
Definitely no.
No, it's a rhetorical question.
Yeah. She's not as bad as Roseanne Barr.
Oh, geez. Yeah, okay, if you're going to go that way.
But
I'll take her
over. You know,
Roseanne
I like
Barr.
Betty White. I know she has different kind of
Betty White.
I really love Betty White.
Oh, Betty White was funny, particularly on Mary Tyler
97
Moore.
97 years old.
Yep.
Did you ever see Mary Tyler Moore, Cammy?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Or Password.
I didn't really, she's funny.
It's a little bit, you're a little young for that, but I grew up with Mary Tyler Moore. And
even Golden Girls, she's hilarious now.
Mm-hmm.
I let that out of the bag.
I
can't help but watch sometimes.
The other woman that was good in that is Cloris Leachman. She's funny. She's been in some Mel Brooks movies.
Yeah, she appears in the oddest places
in
movies
Phyllis.
Sometimes.
And she's still alive, I think, too.
I think so. Yeah, of course.
But she's really old. She's like in her
90s. Older than Betty White?
A little younger, I think.
Okay.
Not much, though. I was shocked how old she is. Because, I think she was born in 1920-something.
Well, people are living a lot longer these days.
Yeah, that's a good sign.
What do you guys think of Ellen DeGeneres?
God, no comment.
Well, I think she's a wonderful...
She was another one I liked early on, I think, at the beginning.
Yeah, she's a great husband.
Some of her early television work was funny.
Yeah.
I think she gets so
much
as
a talk show host, I don't get it as a talk show host. She doesn't do it for me that way, but, you know, for some of her acting and early TV roles were great.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, as a talk show host, no, she doesn't. But then I'm really picky. You know, I grew up with Johnny Carson and Michael Douglas and, you know, like, owns the Beverly Hilton, Merv Griffin.
Oh, well, Merv Griffin I never watched.
These are some of the best.
Was Merv Griffin funny?
No, but in terms of doing an interview and putting out an interesting show, he was good at I thought it was a great show.
Was Merv Griffin gay?
I never thought of it before.
I kind of was.
Cammy, can you referee this for us?
I don't think so. Not that I know of.
I don't know why I thought it. I always associate him with Liberace a little bit.
Oh, because Liberace was always on his show.
Okay, so that's the connection.
Yeah.
But
don't tell me Liberace wasn't gay. Come on.
And that doesn't mean that Merv was gay because Liberace was.
I don't know.
That's true.
All Hollywood's gay for all I know.
I didn't know much about that
West
show.
Hollywood anyway.
Yeah.
Anyway, but I got spoiled by these people here. And then I see this latest generation. Yeah, her doing the daytime. Mike Douglas did a much better daytime. Or Merv Griffin, much better daytime job than Ellen DeGeneres. Just saying. I mean, it's not. And then nighttime stuff, you know, Jay Leno. And all these folks that tried to Letterman. Letterman had a good daytime show.
I liked Letterman.
Yeah,
we played the His Club left from last week.
Well, the early stuff of his was when it was really creative and edgy. It was fantastic.
But Jimmy Kimmel tries, and he's you don't think he's too funny?
No, he's not funny.
Jimmy
Kimmel.
Jimmy Fallon is funny. Oh my God, he is funny. I like him.
Jimmy Fallon. Yeah, you know. Okay. I'll
He was on Saturday Night
Live.
I
like
him. I think Fallon's funny.
I think the comedians I tend to like are the ones on Saturday Night Live. The women, there have been a lot of good women that come out of there.
Oh my gosh! Yeah.
Jane Curtin.
Yeah, Gilda Radner, Jane Curtin, Lorraine Newman.
No, Lorraine Newman.
We had her last week. Remember, on the she did the skit with Reagan. Richard Pryor was taking the devil out of her.
Wow, yeah. That was last week.
That was, yeah, remember that?
Tune back in.
Yeah, Brian, did you hear that one?
Yeah, I did, yeah.
Yeah, so we don't have to play that again, but that was funny, Cammy. You probably should check that out on YouTube.
Yeah, I totally will. I know, like Kate McKinnon on Saturday Night Live. She's the one that does all the impersonations of all the presidents. I love her. To me, she is talented and very funny.
Oh, we could play the... you want to hear a funny Saturday Night Live skit? It's with... let's see if you can guess who the little girl is in this skit. You want to play the play this? Okay. This will be a good one to play. This will be a challenge. You see which one of you guesses this first.
All right, children. Now there's a couple in the next room who are interested in adopting a little boy or a little girl. Now, I haven't met them yet, but I've heard that they're lovely people. They're from New Jersey. Trevor, would you like to live in New Jersey?
That'd be neat.
Aww. Wanda, would you like to live in New Jersey?
I don't want to live in New Jersey. It smells like cheese.
Fine.
She looks like she's laughing.
Now, I'm told that these people have a lovely home with a badminton court. Do you like to play badminton, Trevor?
Oh, I've never played badminton, but I try real hard to learn.
Oh, Wanda?
I hate badminton.
Well, I think it's obvious who has the better attitude here. Trevor, come on, why don't you go in first? Don't be nervous, honey, just be yourself.
Okay, thank you, sister.
Oh, you're quite welcome. There you go. All right, now listen up, crybaby. You've been in this orphanage for 7 years. Count them. I've showed you to 3,000 couples, 42 single parents, and they've all turned you down. I couldn't even give you to the Moonies. Now, do you want to stay here forever?
I don't want to stay here forever.
So straighten up and fly straight.
I don't want to straighten up and fly right.
Oh, I tell you, I don't know. Back so soon?
I'm finished, sister.
Well then, Wanda, it's your turn. Are you going to behave?
I don't want to behave.
Oh, fine. Then blow it again. And you know what? You'll be the only one in the orphanage with liver spots.
She's so cute, that girl.
What? Any guesses?
I have a torch in the door. How old is she? No.
You know, if you don't see it, it's pretty hard to come close. I'll give you a hint. She was she's the granddaughter of a very famous actor.
Their minds not to adopt you. Did you love them, sweetheart?
She's how old do you think she is now?
She's like 8 there.
Oh. Trevor, don't be silly. 30, who in the world would want to adopt Wanda?
This is good.
She's gorgeous.
She's perfect.
And I didn't even get stretch marks.
She even has diverticulitis.
She's a living doll.
I'm gonna be a whiner.
The girl's acting well.
Okay, tell us who she is.
It's Drew Barrymore.
That's Drew Barrymore. Oh my
God! Yeah,
little Drew Barrymore
looks like. But when you look at the girl at that age, she looks like Drew Barrymore. It's like
yeah,
that.
She hasn't changed.
She's got that unique look. Mm-hmm. And Joe Piscopo. It was the Doug and Wendy Weiner thing. You ever seen any of those?
Yep.
Yeah.
Weiners.
Remember that.
Before the Joe Piscopo sex scandal where he had to leave his Senate seat, right?
What was that all about?
Oh, I'm confusing him with Al Franken.
Yeah, that's Al Franken, please.
Isn't that odd, though?
Somebody it's a big difference.
I don't know. They both work for Saturday Night Live.
I like Joe Piscopo.
I like Joe Piscopo, yeah. I'm just kidding. Al Franken was
I'm not an Al Franken fan, really, though he was kind of funny.
At times.
It was funny.
So was Joe Piscopo.
We could probably find some good Al Franken clips from Saturday Night Live.
I actually tried that a couple years ago. It's harder than I think.
You don't think so?
Yeah, that's maybe all there is too. I mean, he's just like, and no, I'm not dissing.
He was the one that did.
There's just a lot of duds.
Stuart Smalley.
Oh boy, you have a good memory.
Remember Stuart Smalley?
No, I don't.
Yeah, we could find some good ones.
I do.
Mm-hmm. Stuart Smalley.
Yeah. So did you, Cammy? Did you like that?
I did. It was cute.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
So Cammy, as a freelancer, you were going to mention earlier, are your, a lot of your stuff on hold right now?
Well, I wouldn't say so much on hold, but I'm not pursuing right now. Of course, nobody is, but yeah, pretty much.
Well, that means it's on hold. I mean, at some point it'll.
Everything's on hold. Yeah, I mean, I supposedly have a comedy scene that I'm supposed to be doing for a show, a web series, but that's on hold right now. So,
do you have any sense of what the future, of like mass, when we might even be able to have a group larger than 10 approved?
Exactly.
Maybe after Easter.
This, you know?
And then are we going to have, if it's a theater of 350 people, it'd be limited to, 75 or something like that?
Yeah, who knows?
Let's face it, we're probably in for a bad week coming up. And the week after, it's probably not going to be great, but maybe things will be improving. And then, I kind of think by maybe the end of May, we might start going back to work.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know California, the death tolls are going down. I know that. California and Washington are actually doing better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That is for sure.
Yeah, New York State.
Flattening out here in California. Yeah,
yeah,
but
we're going to be spared the worst of it.
But not New Jersey and New York,
unfortunately,
and not New Orleans.
New York's doing terrible right now.
Or Detroit,
New Orleans.
There's so many people,
Yeah, it's the density.
You know who died recently of this? Was the cause was stated as coronavirus. It was Tom Dempsey, the guy that kicked
out. Yeah, I just saw that.
Yeah, that was pretty sad.
Tom Dempsey.
Yeah.
He's a kicker, right?
The kicker. He kicked the 63-yard field goal.
Oh, yeah. Tom Dempsey.
The Saints.
Really?
Huh.
Oh, do you know how old he was? Huh. Was he in his 70s? He wasn't that old.
Well,
60s?
Don't you think when he kicked it?
1970, I think he kicked.
67,
yeah, and nobody touched it.
Was
for,
it 70?
Like,
67? Okay.
Yeah, so it's going to put him up in his late 70s, early 80s. Okay.
He's probably like my parents' age, and my parents are in their late 70s.
Okay. That sounds about right.
So, it's, yeah.
We used to call that death by old age, but yeah.
I think you're probably going to see regions going back to normalcy periodically as things improve, but it won't be like a countrywide thing.
I'd just be happy to see this region go back to something other than we have to. I can walk into a building and order a alcoholic drink and it can be served to me in the presence of other people doing the same.
Or you can go into a bank and not be interrogated about your health.
Yeah, yeah.
I heard Donald Trump had a call with a bunch of the major league commissioners and stuff.
Oh,
yes, he did.
What was it? What do you think they're talking about doing?
Just basically talking about when and if they can get things started again, to get the sports world back up and running. Yeah,
that would make
people don't know any ideas yet. But
that would make people feel better.
I had an idea of myself. I just hit my head yesterday.
Sure.
I think I put it on Sports Rock. And I said, if they just want to get things done, just forget your 8-16-team playoff round and stuff and get right to it. They could just put Milwaukee and the Lakers 7 games, championship. There you go.
Yeah.
They're the top two teams anyway. They could do a similar thing with hockey. Just take the four... division,
best out of three or something even, and reduce it to four teams total, just to get something done.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's.
They're talking about doing some one and duns in basketball, for example. I heard they're talking about doing like the NCAA for some of those early rounds.
Relatively little risk if they can test people, right?
Yeah, but then you got to put them up in hotels, and then they got to eat in restaurants, so it's just exposure, and it's a group. It's a,
Yeah, exactly.
Even to get a team together.
Then I heard another one that NBA might just centralize the whole thing in Las Vegas instead of traveling.
Okay, well, I'm just saying.
It's back to a group of 10.
Once the 10 group
once
changes.
The 10 thing drops, then this all can work.
Yeah. So.
I think we'll have testing under control. That's really the thing. I mean, everybody really, to help calm everyone down, because the press is doing a useless job communicating this right now. And that is, despite whatever you want to say about the CDC or our medical system or anything else, they're all running with a blindfold on because we don't have any data. And we don't have any data because the early Chinese data was lying. So we've only been able to track since it came to Italy, and that was 2 months ago.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't have enough data because we don't have enough tests.
We got to get more data.
And we got the best medical system in terms of getting stuff out in the world, but it's going to take a little more than 30 days to get all the testing under control. But that being said, it won't take longer than 90 days, not the United States of America. And once we have the data, then everything's going back to normal. Because then we know exactly.
Yeah, we know what we're dealing with.
Yeah, then we know what to deal with. Okay, here's who has to go out. This is who doesn't have to go out. We're going to know. And this isn't going to take a year. And society's not going to fall apart, like Tank was saying, even though it's dystopian, interesting from a dystopian philosophical point of view to play with ideas. But it's not going to happen. We're going to get this under control. So.
All right.
That's my positive for the
everybody. Society. Everybody, things are going to be all right, is what Eric said, and I believe him.
It's going to be patient. We just have to somehow live through this right now. You know, my parents, they lived through, as children lived through, the Second World War, and that was like 4 years of weird behavior, of people missing in your life. Some never returned.
Mm-hmm.
Others dying prematurely because of the stress of it.
And we've been through Vietnam.
Yeah, but this is more of a national, you know, like there was no rationing during Vietnam. There was no Second World War called for, behavior that we didn't like to do, like social distancing and crap like that.
Yeah, you're right. There was, that's a very good comparison. World War II.
So we're a nation
shut
that
down
can make,
or redirect themselves, redirect their energy and give up, sacrifice things.
Yeah. We're survivors.
Yeah, we are a nation. Our history is one of being able to supplant our those needs in order for the better of the nation. We did it in World War II, and we'll do it. Yeah, it's in our DNA. Maybe that wasn't us who lived there, but it was my parents and my relatives. It's in our DNA. We'll do it. Jabba, you come from Russia, man. You guys, your DNA knows nothing but suffering.
Oh, I had my great-grandmother.
That's why they drink so much vodka.
Speaking of typhus, my great-grandmother on my father's side died of typhus on a train.
There you go.
And she was trying to get out of Eastern Europe. So.
And Cammy, your people are from San Bernardino, so you know a thing or two about suffering, too.
You talk about Riverside?
Sorry, Riverside.
I have some family out there. My two sons are out there.
That's right.
We were broadcasting out there, so don't to be nice to them.
Riverside doesn't count.
Riverside County here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, you are. Where at?
In Riverside. I'm in Banning, California.
Oh my gosh, you're way out there.
He's been banished to Banning. Yep.
Banning.
I'm just kidding.
He's banned.
Well, we're coming up on the end of the show here, so I just I wanted to thank you guys, you girls and guys, Cammy. Thank you very much for being a part of our
lady
show.
Lady and gentleman, singular.
Yeah, and
you're very welcome. Thanks for having me on.
Your charming presence on our show. Check her out at on the Cammy Burnett YouTube page and also your Facebook page, right?
Yes, and Instagram.
And then Brian.
Yes, I will check her out. Thanks, Cammy.
Thanks, Brian.
Yeah, Brian.
Yeah, and I'm a promoter on Sports Rock. That's Brian's popular
Sports
site.
Rock was one of the many Facebook pages that Brian, the administrator of all administrators, administrates.
Mm-hmm.
He's very good at what he does. So
sports and rock. We didn't even get a chance to talk about the low spark or high heeled boys, but perhaps next week.
Okay.
That was a good post this week. That was a great album.
And check out Pete Browning, Brian. If you already haven't, he's got a very interesting life.
Yeah, you had me. I looked him up last night. Yeah. So that's a Great story, and yes, Hall of Fame worthy, yes, of course. Yeah.
Gladiator. So, Cammy, we'll be in touch. Thank you so much for calling in, Eric, as usual. Thank you for providing the studio.
You're welcome. Nice chatting with you guys.
And so we're going to send you off with one of my favorite Rolling Stones songs. It kind of is something I'm always thinking about lately, The Hand of Fate, and how much we control what happens to us, but that we're all stuck in the same predicament. So this is a great song. It's got a nice guitar work in it. Rolling Stones from the Black and Blue album.
All right, I'll catch you next time, boys.
All right.